Well, airlines are coming under enormous pressure to keep up with demand as hundreds of thousands of people flock to Queensland.
But worker shortages and record-breaking passenger numbers are leading to frustrating cancellations, leaving some people stranded.
What was supposed to be a week-long tropical escape to Queensland has turned into a nightmare to get home.
There's nothing we can do about it.
Emma, Christy, their son and his friend were meant to fly home to Victoria on Friday, but their return flight was cancelled twice.
They've rebooked us on a flight on the Sunday morning, leave at 3 a.m. To get to the airport, and just before boarding, it just flicks over to cancelled with no announcement, no comment.
Jetstar's put them up in a hotel for two of the four nights before their third attempt to leave.
We're $30 a day each for food and, yeah, just waiting for our flight on Tuesday.
It's an all too familiar scene. Flights delayed, cancelled or missed, leaving passengers stranded, sometimes for days. That's because flights are so tightly packed and sick aircrew are leaving fewer workers to operate the routes.
Most frontline services at the moment are feeling the effects of the new wave of COVID plus influenza. People are doing the right thing and not turning up to work when they're sick, but that's having an impact on service.
Good luck to anyone trying to rebook or find a same-day flight. If you tried booking a direct same-day interstate flight this morning, you would have been struggling. Only Qantas was offering direct flights to Sydney for between $260 to $1,800. There were no available flights to Melbourne, and the same for Canberra, with nothing available.
It is becoming increasingly hard to travel at the last moment, so if you do have any plans, make sure you're exploring them now because the seats may not be available when you want to travel.
Today, 65,000 people flocked through Brisbane Airport, 57,000 in the domestic terminal alone. And those figures confirm that the Brisbane Airport has had its busiest day on record since the pandemic. If that demand keeps up over the coming weeks, those numbers could even surpass the pre-pandemic numbers. And Melissa, we're being told to start thinking ahead for the September holidays and even Christmas if we want a chance at securing flights for a reasonable price.
Some forward planning needed, Josh. Thank you.